exhibits explore black and white photography and bold color. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Mike Anderson. He is with the Reading Public Museum. Thanks for being with us.
Hi, thanks for asking.
Two great new exhibits, but very, very different. Let's first start with one that's about black and white photography. This is amazing photography. Some of it dates back to the 1930s. These are pieces now in the permanent collection at the Reading Public Museum, but these are original prints from the 1930s, 40s, up to 1950.
Right. These are vintage prints. The exhibit's called Barbara Morgan Photography. Obviously, Barbara Morgan is the photographer. And these were all vintage prints that were made during her lifetime. And as you mentioned, from the 20s, but a lot of the major part of the collection is from the 30s.
And very recognizable in a lot of ways, because we're looking at Martha Graham dancers, beautiful prints, incredible lighting, and when you talk about the lines of these dancers, she was able to capture the shadows and the movement of these women in dramatic and incredible ways.
They're exquisite, and the fact that they're in our Works on Paper gallery, which I always say is a very intimate gallery, it's a really nice way to experience the subtleties of the prints that you don't necessarily catch when you look at them online or anywhere else. These are the real silver prints. So, very, very exciting. We have dancers, we have portraits, a few landscapes and some photo montages, but a lot of the dance work is covered within the exhibit.
And we mentioned that these prints are now part of the permanent collection of the museum.
They are. Recently we got a nice gift of the majority of them, and we augmented that collection with some purchases, so they are part of our permanent collection, and we won't have them out on exhibit constantly, so we can bring them out and feature them now through May 5th. They'll be in our Works on Paper gallery. So. It's really a nice quality exhibit, and probably a relief from looking at Jelly Belly or some of the Lego exhibit we have going on.
And we'll talk about that in just a second. But moving from the shadow and the beauty of some of these dancers featured as part of Barbara Morgan Photography, let's talk a little bit about Jules Olitski on an intimate scale. This is color applied brightly and thickly to canvas, but it's done so in a way, even though it's on a small scale, that these paintings have big impact.
Right. You can see the scale there. They're about 2 feet, roughly, at the maximum, and they cover several of the walls within our Cohen Modern Contemporary galleries. But you're right. The color and the texture of the paint is what makes them outstanding and very striking. So they are all within one area of that gallery. Pretty exciting. You mentioned some of the techniques. It's everything from staining the canvas, very experimental and very abstract. Staining the canvas, spraying it with different acrylic paints or oils. You went through a Baroque style, a Baroque period, a High Baroque, and Late Orb. All kinds of names for these different periods of art. It's just incredible to see. It's very, very moving when you get to see them up close.
And this actually premiered at George Washington University's Luther W. Brady Gallery and really made a splash there and is now at the Reading Public
Museum.
It
did, no pun intended, made a splash there. Yes, and now it's at the Reading Public Museum. It's part of the Olitski family estate, so this show has not traveled and has not been seen together like this, and it's a very, very famous artist in that realm.
And just a very few seconds left, but your kids' programs are going on. We can still visit Legos and other great programs.
Oh yeah, so this is a nice purist art thing to check out as well.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank
Good to
you.
See you, Mike. We've been talking with Mike Anderson of the Reading Public Museum. I'm Jill Horner.